right, you're going to be running a wire for a switch to go to an outside light in front of the garage. And if you look closely here, the wire is made here in the country I was born, and that is a very, very nice thing to see. So we're going to mount a box right here. Okay, so now we're going to come out of this box and come over. We're going to hook into this. She can't. Don't get upset. Don't frustrate. Don't carry on. It's just not worth it. It isn't. It's just not worth it. You just got to keep raking that little piece of wood out. Rake it out. Roll your screwdriver. You just buy another one because I don't have a good one. So we're just going to have to put a nail plate over this here. Now we'll get our other wire coming down through here. Okay, now we're ready to hook our light switch up. So we'll put our wires up here. Off. Okay, so now we're going to make our pigtail to go to our green screw on the switch. Interesting, even way there. And get our round tail in here. Okay, I'll cut it. Let's use them with the shortest here, like this. Put my wire nut onto it. Make sure it's all nice and tight. And now we'll get our light wires together here. We'll strip it with our number 12 hole. You can see the wire gauges on the wire strippers there. You always match the size wire you're using. Okay, we'll get our place even at the bottom here. Get them twisted together. Got it going nice and evenly here. Yeah, one's a little longer than the other. I'll put them so they're even. Put my wire nut on. Make sure my insulation's going up into the bottom of our wire cap, which it is. Okay, so now we can fold our light wires into our box. Get them back out of our way here. So we're going to put in a switch. This has the pressure plates on them, so we just stick the wires under the pressure plate and we'll tighten the screw. But we have to wrap our ground wire around our green screw. So we'll take our needle nose pliers and make a loop the direction our screw turns. Put it under our green screw like that. Hold our loop like that around the screw the direction our screw turns. And we'll just tighten it up. Like that, make sure we're going to pull it out a little bit on that wire so it goes around. So the copper is under the screw head all the way around. I'll just close the loop a little bit more. There it is. That's how we want our wire under the screw head. Okay, now we'll look here and see which one is the top and the bottom. So this is the top here, so we'll push our ground wire in. And now we'll hook our two black wires up. Okay, so we'll strip a little bit, like maybe a half of an inch off of our two black wires. Here in the country I was born in, your black is live, your white is neutral, the bare, the green is the brown. Red and blue are also live colors. However, you may find white live in a switch loop or a 220-240 volt circuit where the appliance does not require a neutral, and you always switch your hot wire. In this case, the switch is before the light, so we'll put our two black wires on the switch. You want to make sure you don't get too much copper showing behind that pressure plate there. We'll fold our wires to go into our box. You can take a look at how that's hooked up there. And then go grab some screws. Anyway, got some screws so you can see how this is wired. And I push this into our box. I'll make sure our ground wire stays away from our live terminals here. Here in the country I was born in, up is on, down is off on your single pole switches, but on a three-way switch it could be either way depending on the opposite switch. So this is ready for a covering. So next we'll hook up to where the power source is. Alright, so we're going to be hooking into this box here. This is just a light, so it does not have to be GFI protected. This switch here turns on and off this GFI for the pool pump. So we're going to come in into here. Okay, we'll stick a staple in here. not hooked up to anything. Pull the rest of this into our box. Strip some more wires out. All our debris out. Okay, so first we'll get our ground wires hooked up here. Make sure they're all even on the end. We'll put our wire nut back on here. Okay, so we'll take our black one that's coming from our breaker, and we'll put the black up here onto the switch. Now this switch is designed to have two wires under one terminal. Okay, strip it. Take off about a half an inch. I'll hold it up to our pressure plate, make sure we get it fits under there all the way. We'll loosen the screw up. Put our wire under, make sure our copper, you can see the copper at the top of the pressure plate, which I do see. I'm going to use the flathead to snug that down. Make sure it's nice and tight, and I see just like a 16th of an inch of copper at the top there. And now I'll come down here. I'll have to take the white off this GFI because you can only put one wire on a screw terminal. So we'll open our terminal up here. So we'll make a tail to go to our GFI and a tail to go into our wire nut here. Okay, we'll get our insulation even at the bottom here. We'll get our twist started here. Get our third wire in here, get them even like that. We'll twist them in. Make sure it stays nice and even here. I'll clip them so they're all even on the end here like that. I'll look, 1, 2, 3, all our wires are even, so I'll go get another wire nut. Make sure our insulation is going up under the to the bottom of the wire nut there. Now we can put this white wire back on our screen screw here. That takes a smidgen more off of here, not a lot, because I want to make sure I don't get the insulation caught under the screw head. So I always put your wire around the screw, the direction the screw turns. Get it under there. Close it the direction the screw turns like that. Make sure it's nice and tight like that. That's what we want. And now we can put all this back into our box here. So we'll get our white wires back here out of our way. Get our ground wire back here out of the way. We'll put our switch back in here, keeping our ground wire back away from our terminals here. Okay, I want to bend it back this way so it stays away from our conductors there. And make sure our ground wire is back away from everything here. Now we can push our GFI back into our box here. Keeping that ground wire back away from everything here. Push it back all the way.
Drilling and cutting the hole.
Who's the ass
inside?
I don't know. I don't know where the dog is.
No, fucking
dog. Oh. Yeah, he's inside, I think. One, two, three, four. We got a staple here, and this wire's back out of our way. This is about the ceiling over here, so come down here. Now I'll come over to like where the middle is, where the light's gonna be. This is above the door, so it's out of the way of getting pinched. So this is the middle, and we're going to cut the hole in the middle here. So I'll put my last staple up here. Alrighty, so that is how to wire from outlet with a GFI in it, non-protected, because it's not needed by the GFI, for a switch, which is here, and this wire goes up above the garage door for the motion light that's going to be put up there in the near future. Here in the country I was born in, we use 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps, 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. Black is live, white is neutral, the bare of the green is the ground. Red and blue are also live colors. However, you may find white live in a switch loop or a 240 volt circuit where the appliance does not require a neutral. Peace. Thanks for watching.